It's the first innovation in hypertension treatment in more than a decade. Gracilis has received Health Canada approval for the treatment of mild to moderate high blood pressure. Dr. Subodh Verma is a cardiac surgeon at St. Michael's Hospital in Toronto and a Canadian research chair in atherosclerosis.
Gracilis is a significant advance in treatment because it inhibits renin. Renin is an important molecule that is involved in the development of elevated blood pressure, and Gracilis is the first agent approved in Canada that directly inhibits or blocks renin.
Controlling hypertension isn't easy, and nearly 64% of patients require a combination of treatments to attain healthy blood pressure levels. Despite the advances made in treating hypertension, there's a clear need for new treatment options that will get patients controlled. When added to many existing therapies, Gracilis has been shown to provide 38 to 48% more blood pressure reduction.
Clearly, the two challenges that I face in treating high blood pressure is getting people to goal, i.e. getting them to a target blood pressure, and in fact ensuring that people stay on their medication. We recommend that people stay on a certain regimen, but compliance still remains the Achilles heel when it comes to high blood pressure. Gracilis has several unique attributes that makes it a very favorable agent for patients with mild to moderate hypertension or high blood pressure. First, it is a very effective blood pressure lowering medication. Second, it is able to lower blood pressure effectively with a very low side effect profile. In fact, it is exceedingly well tolerated by patients. Third, it mixes and matches quite well with patients' background medications for high blood pressure.
High blood pressure, which affects one in five Canadians, is often referred to as a silent killer, as it can't be seen or felt. It's the number one risk factor for stroke and a major risk factor for heart disease.
I urge all of our patients out there to stay on their medications, to get to their target, because if they can do those two things, they may not feel much better, but certainly this will offer huge dividends with respect to reduction of heart attack, stroke, kidney risk, etc.
Lifestyle changes such as diet and exercise can help, but most people will require medication to help get their blood pressure within healthy ranges. Canadians now have a new therapeutic option to help get them to goal. For more information about treatment options that are right for you, speak with your doctor. Sherry Demitarco reporting.